compute the center of mass x bar of a rod of density rho equals 7 with x on the open interval from negative 4 to 6. So we can think of the rod lying along the x-axis. It starts at x equals negative 4. It ends at x equals 6. We can think of the center mass as the balance point of the rod, where you could place your finger along the x-axis and the rod would balance horizontally. For example, we can think of this location as the center of mass. Again, the point where the rod would balance horizontally. Because the rod has constant density, the center of mass is going to be the midpoint of the rod, which means to determine the center of mass, we can simply determine the average of negative 4 and positive 6. The center of mass, x bar, is equal to the sum of negative 4 and 6 divided by 2, which equals 2 divided by 2, which equals 1. The center of mass is equal to 1. Another way to find the center of mass would be to find the length of the rod and then add that length to the left side of the rod. For example, the length of the rod L is equal to 6 minus negative 4, which equals positive 10, and the length of the rod divided by 2 is equal to 5. We could also determine the center of mass by starting at the left x value of negative 4 and then adding 5, which equals positive 1. Either way, we get the same result. But this only works when the density is constant. If the density is not constant, then we determine the center of mass along the x-axis by determining the quotient of the moment about the origin and the mass, where the moment about the origin is equal to the integral from a to b of x times rho of x dx, and the mass equals the integral from a to b of rho of x dx. Let's show we get the same result using this formula as well. Let's first determine the moment about the origin, which equals the integral from negative 4 to 6 of x times rho of x, which is x times 7, or 7x. Integrating, we have 7 times x squared divided by 2, or 7 halves x squared. Let's go ahead and factor out the 7 halves. Which gives us 7 halves times the difference of the square of 6 and the square of negative 4, which is equal to 7 halves times the difference of 36 and 16, which is 20, which equals 70. And now let's determine the mass. The mass equals the integral from negative 4 to 6 of 70x. The antiderivative is 7x. Let's factor out the 7, which gives us 7 times the difference of 6 and a negative 4, which is equal to 7 times 10, which is 70. Of course, we get the same result. The center of mass, x bar, is equal to the moment about the origin divided by the mass, which does give us x bar equals 1. I hope you found this helpful.